To calibrate meter soil moisture sensors, we recommend a method based on weighing the entire calibration sample. To perform a calibration, you will need the following items. Meter sensor output is very similar among sensors of the same type. You can calibrate with a single sensor and apply that calibration to other sensors of that type in your soil and maintain excellent accuracy. Begin by measuring the mass of the clean, dry calibration container. Record the tear mass in the calibration spreadsheet entitled Table 1, Method A. Table 1 can be downloaded at the web address below. It automatically calculates the calibration function after you enter in all the values. For accurate sample collection, choose representative soil from the area and depth you wish to measure with your meter sensors. Collect approximately 4 liters, or 1 gallon, of bulk soil. If you wish to measure the field bulk density of the soil, use a sampler with a known volume to collect a soil core of undisturbed soil. Oven dry the soil core. After the soil is dry, measure the mass of the soil. Use this equation to calculate the bulk density of the soil, where rho sub b, the bulk density, equals the mass of the dry soil divided by the known volume that you collected. To prepare the bulk soil sample, air dry the soil. Air drying is quickest if the soil is spread in a thin layer and air is moved over the soil. Large rocks or other objects can complicate the calibration process. Remove the rocks, grind the soil, and run the soil through a 2 mm sieve before proceeding. In some materials, such as compost or mulch, it's not possible to remove large particulates without significantly altering the nature of the material. To start the calibration, pack the soil into the calibration container at approximately the field bulk density. If you start with dry soil, control the bulk density by packing a known mass of soil into a known container volume. It's generally necessary to add the soil in layers, packing each layer before adding the next. To determine the initial air-dry water content, take a small subsample. First, measure the mass of a clean, dry soil drying container. Record the tear mass in Table 1. Remove 5 to 10 grams of soil with a scoopula and place it into the drying container. To prevent water loss from the soil, immediately measure the mass of the soil plus the drying container. Record the weight in Table 1. Set the sample aside to be oven dried later. Weigh the entire calibration container with soil before inserting the sensor. Record the mass in Table 1. For fine textured soils, like silt loam and clay soils, take a height measurement from the lid down to the base of the soil. Over time, the volume of finer textured soils will change with the addition of water. Sandy soils don't have this issue. If a height measurement is taken and the dimensions of the container are known, then it's possible to perform a volume change correction in the volumetric water content calculation. For instructions on performing a volume change correction, contact customer support. Next, plug the sensor into the same data logger or ZSC handheld you'll use in the field. The output of analog sensors is often dependent on the input voltage from the logging source. Because of this, it's best to use the same device for calibration. The EC5 or 10HS can be inserted vertically directly into the full soil container. Insert the sensor tines in a straight line so as not to introduce any air gaps between the soil sensor tines and the soil. Insert the sensor fully into the soil. This includes the black plastic base of the sensor. If you cannot insert the black plastic portion fully into the soil, insert the sensor as far as possible. Then take some additional soil and pack it around the remaining portion of the sensor base and a few centimeters of the cable, if possible. To insert taro sensors, move some soil to prepare a flat spot. Push the sensor into the soil. Pack soil around the exposed portion of the sensor, being careful to prevent air gaps while maintaining the desired bulk density. Make sure there's approximately 1 centimeter of soil over the top of the sensor. All types of sensors should be surrounded by continuous soil for the entire radius of the sensor volume of influence. See the manual to find the volume of influence for your particular sensor. Take a sensor reading. If using non-meter data acquisition equipment with an EC5, be sure you are exciting the sensor with the same excitation voltage you will use in the field. All other meter sensors regulate their excitation voltage, so refer to the manual for the appropriate voltage range. Collect the raw data from the sensor with no calibration applied. It's a good idea to repeat the steps of sensor insertion and taking a reading once or twice to ensure you're achieving repeatable insertion quality. Be careful not to insert the sensor into holes you've already made. There will generally be some small variability in readings, a few raw counts or millivolts, so an average reading can be taken. Record sensor readings in Table 1. As evenly as possible, wet the calibration soil by adding about 10 milliliters of water for every 100 milliliters of soil volume. This will increase volumetric water content by 10%. For sandy soils, we recommend adding 5 to 7 milliliters of water per 100 milliliters of soil for a 5 to 7 increase in volumetric water content. Thoroughly mix the soil with your hands or a trowel until the mixture is again homogeneous. Repeat the steps of packing the soil, inserting the sensor, taking a reading, weighing, and recording. Then again, increase the volumetric water content by 10%. Repeat these steps until the soil nears saturation. This generally yields 4 to 6 calibration points. Each point may take up to 1 hour. Note that the bulk density of the sample can be maintained throughout the calibration process by packing the same soil sample to the same level on the calibration container at each water content. To dry the initial volumetric soil sample, place all of the already weighed sample into the 105 degrees Celsius oven for 24 hours. Note that the soils with high organic matter content may lose significant volatile organics if dried at 105 degrees Celsius, leading to error in the calibration. We recommend drying these soils at 60 to 70 degrees Celsius for at least 48 hours. Remove the soil drying container from the oven. Place the container in a desiccant chamber and allow it to cool. Measure the mass of the dry soil plus the container. Enter the dry mass into Table 1. The table spreadsheet automatically calculates the calibration function. For instructions on how to apply the calibration function to your raw data, refer to our website.